Hey YouTube, it's Student Witch and I'm here for some health and beauty favorites, and I just wanted to start off right off the bat with some Tears of the Patriarchy. This is what keeps me going. It's my favorite health and beauty item of the year 2017. Every morning I drink a big cup and it keeps me looking young and fresh and helps me be a badass. I'm just kidding, let's get to the real stuff. Alright, for real this time. So, welcome to my couch. Well, actually, you guys are propped up on my work desk station, so that's why you're a little up and I'm kind of looking up at you. But, yeah, let's get to the real stuff. Welcome to my 2017 health and beauty favorites, and I just recently uploaded a video on my channel of my 2017 witchy favorites, and the News Fluffle subscriber, that's the name of their channel on YouTube, they requested that I make the 2017 health and beauty favorites video, because I was gonna make or combine the witchy and the health and beauty all together, but the witchy video ended up being like epically long. So I decided to kind of cut it off with just the witchy stuff, and I actually wasn't going to make this video, but the News Fluffle commented in that video saying that they would really like to see the health and beauty favorites video for this year because they enjoyed one of my recent I think like October health and beauty favorites video that I did. So I have before me on my desk, I'm looking at all these beautiful things right now, and it was really hard to pick my health and beauty favorites, but I think I narrowed it down to the essential stuff, and not Tears of the Patriarchy, but the tea that I'm drinking here is going to be the first thing that I'm going to talk about. But first, let me just give a general caveat or warning. I'm not a health professional. The things, the different types of essential oils and supplements and things that I'm about to talk about are things that I decided to take and to ingest and to put on my body after I did extensive research and decided that I wanted to try these things out, and my experience has been that these things have helped me a lot. So please do not take my word for gold. Please do not just take my word for it. Again, this video is not meant to be any sort of advice or instructions about how to take these different tinctures or supplements or anything. This is just my experience. So yeah, don't take my word for it, and do your research before you decide to take any herbal supplement or anything like that. That being said, so the tea that I'm drinking, which is my most favorite tea in the world, and I've talked about it several times in different videos on this channel, is the Tulsi Sweet Rose Tea, the Organic India brand. And you can order this on Amazon, but I get this either at the Whole Foods that's down the street from me, because I'm kind of in a bougie suburb or whatever of Boston, the greater Boston area, so I live down the street from a Whole Foods. or I also get it at a hippie independent health food store called Cambridge Naturals, which is in Cambridge, Massachusetts, right? Which I frequent often because I like to support local business, and they have really great stuff. So this is the tea that I'm drinking. Tulsi is also known as holy basil, and it is supposed to be a nervine. I know herbalists out there, you know what I'm talking about, like the different categories of different herbs and the herbs that affect the nervous system and the mood. Herbs that are like calming, like chamomile is a very gentle one, for example, or St. John's wort is another more serious or stronger example. So yes, this is what I'm drinking right now. I love this flavor. They have all sorts of different flavors, like Tulsi, or holy basil plus mint or holy basil plus this or that, and I've been meaning to get around to trying the other ones, but every time I run out of this, I just immediately restock just in this one. It's so sweet and calming and delicious. I love roses. So kind of speaking of St. John's wort, I do have mixed in here, in addition to my honey, I have some tinctures that I have used throughout the course of 2017. And these tinctures are specifically to help me manage my depression and anxiety and to help me sleep. So if you've been following my channel for a good bit or for a few months, you'll probably know that I spoke very openly about going back on medication. I have a history of depression for a whole host of reasons, but not going to get into that right now. But I do have a history of depression and anxiety, and between early March and early September, that 6-month period, I was on a very low dose of Zoloft. I, with the help of my psychiatrist, weaned myself off of that because I felt like I no longer needed it, because external stressors in my life were alleviated, or I didn't feel quite as impacted by them as I did earlier this year. So I'm no longer on medication. I say that, and it's important that I say that, because one of the tinctures or herbs that I use is St. John's wort. And the Cambridge Natural Store, this is their store brand of the tincture. But I'm about to show you another more like name brand that I believe you can order online if you don't have access to a store like a natural health food store or a Whole Foods, I think. I think you can order them online, but this is the Cambridge Natural store brand of St. John's wort tincture. And this is in, grain alcohol. And so St. John's wort is kind of like a natural antidepressant, but there's important things that you need to know about it. First of all, it can cause photosensitivity, so it can make you sensitive to sunlight. I have not experienced that, but I'm also in Massachusetts, where in the wintertime the sun sets at like 4:12 in the afternoon, so I'm not exposed to a lot of sunlight. This might be a good herb to try if you have seasonal affective disorder, now that I think about it, because if you're affected by the winter and the shorter days and darker times, then this might be a good thing to try. But anyway, photosensitivity, but also if you are already taking any sort of mental health medication, whether it is for anxiety or depression or bipolar or whatever, do not take this herb, because this is kind of like a natural SSRI. So it affects your serotonin levels. It's probably not as strong as medication, but if you're already taking medication and then on top of that you take this, it could cause dangerously high levels of serotonin. So don't take this if you're already taking a prescription medication for depression, anxiety, bipolar, whatever. Okay? That's why I waited to get back on this, because I was taking this last year too, but then I decided I needed more support. So that's why I went on Zoloft, very small dose, I think the smallest possible dose of Zoloft. Then I eased myself and weaned myself off of that over a period of time, and then I went back on this, because this, just one dropper full in the morning mixed with my orange juice was enough and is enough. I've had really good experiences with this. Another tincture that is also the Cambridge Naturals brand is Skullcap. And chamomile, rosemary, skullcap, motherwort, St. John's wort, I believe they are all in the mint family, if I'm not mistaken. And the mint family are all, they're all supportive of the nervous system and of your mood, right? So skullcap is a really great, gentle, relaxing herb. I also have it in my tea right now, and I take it in the evening to help me kind of wind down and get ready to go to bed. So again, with any and all of these tinctures that I'm talking about, do your research, consult your medical people in your life, and if definitely if you're pregnant or breastfeeding, don't take any of them, just to be safe, right? Skullcap is great to help wind down in the evening. When I am on my period, when I, like the first day or the day before my period, because thanks to charting with the fertility awareness method, I know exactly when my period's gonna start. I'll talk about that here in a second. But when I'm on my period, and it's the very beginning of my period, it's my heavy day, it's the shitty day, I take 10 drops of motherwort. Is this gonna get into focus? Please focus, don't focus on me. There we go. Motherwort, and this is the brand that I believe you can find this at Whole Foods if you live near Whole Foods, or I think you can order from them online. It's called Gaia. Oh, there's a glare. Gaia Organics, okay? I don't know if that's gonna focus. There we go. Sorry. The lighting sucks. It's the evening already. The sun has set because it's 4 o'clock in Massachusetts, and so the lighting is not ideal. But anyway, motherwort is great. It is also a nervine, whatever. This is good if you're experiencing heightened anxiety. You can take some of this, like a whole dropper full mixed with juice. It's pretty bitter, so definitely try to mix it with something. It supports the heart, because I believe, if I remember correctly, the Latin name for motherwort is something like Leonis cardiaca, so the lion-hearted. So it's good for the heart, but it also supports and helps to strengthen the uterus and contractions and the flow out of the uterus. So definitely do not take this if you're pregnant. Although I have heard of women who, once they have entered labor, so they're already in the process of getting that baby out, they will take this to help induce contractions naturally. But again, if you're pregnant, especially the early stages of pregnancy when miscarriage is more likely, don't take this. and consult your midwife or whoever you're working with before you decide to work with this when you're in labor, right? And if you're breastfeeding, don't take this. But I use this as a support to help with the flow to get everything out once I'm menstruating. And I've had really good experience with it. It's been very supportive during that time, that hormonal time. And lastly, another tincture that I have in my tea right now is a tincture that I made myself. It's the first tincture I made. I made a big jar of it, so I'm still working my way through it. But I call this my tranquil sleep tincture, and it's basically just equal parts chamomile, rose petals, and lavender. And I just put it in my tea in the evening to help me wind down. Since it was my first experience making a tincture, I wanted to use very, very safe herbs. Like chamomile is very gentle. It's not, there's not as many like warnings about it, like taking St. John's wort, for example. And the same thing with rose petals and lavender. So I made this with vodka, and I put it in my tea in the evening, along with my skullcap and along with my St. John's wort if I feel like I need a second dose that day for whatever reason. And those have been very supportive and helpful. And I feel like I feel kind of empowered using herbs to support myself and my physical and mental health. It feels good. So, yes. What should I talk about next? I'm gonna go with CBD oil. CBD oil. CBD oil or cannabidiol. It is found in plants, in the cannabis plant, or hemp. This is hemp derived because even though Massachusetts has voted to legalize marijuana, it is not, I think it's not going to be for sale for recreational use until January. Right when I move out. Right when I move back to Georgia, damn it, no. I have imbibed, but it's been almost a year since I have imbibed and I needed a break from it. So I got this again at the hippie store, Cambridge Naturals. It is hemp derived, so technically this is legal in all 50 states because it's not from wacky weed cannabis, this is from the hemp cannabis. And cannabidiol is a very, from what I've researched, a very safe and effective option for helping you sleep and for helping you manage stress and anxiety. This is a very low concentration. This is just 3 milligrams per serving, so 3 milligrams per 15 drops. And I also purchased, but ran out of, a 10 milligram dose that came in a pill form. And I would just take one in the morning, one 10 milligram in the morning, and then one 10 milligram before going to bed, when I was stressed out about my first exam that I took earlier this semester. Now I actually haven't taken it in probably a month because I ran out of the pills and they're kind of pricey. It's like $60 for a bottle of 60 pills. So that would be like a month's supply for me. You can order this online and have it shipped anywhere within at least the continental United States legally still, although the federal government and the FDA is all sorts of fucked up in all sorts of different ways. So if you're interested in taking CBD oil to aid you in whichever way, just keep your eyes peeled in the news about it. Yeah, but again, hemp derived, it does not make you high or anything. It has a very calming and very gentle effect. But I would recommend if you are interested in taking it, but again, do your research. and if you're already taking anti-anxiety medication, like prescription medication, I wouldn't add this to the mix because you don't know how these things are going to interact. I took this because I wasn't on any prescriptions when I started taking it. And I found it did help me. It helped me sleep through the night. I didn't really wake up in the middle of the night as often as I did previously. And I really do feel like it helped me manage my anxiety more, which was really nice. So I started with a 3 milligrams per dose and then I eventually increased it to 10 milligrams per dose. And then when I was really stressed out about exam, I took 2 doses of 10 milligrams in the form of a pill. So even though I haven't taken this in a while, my husband does take it to help him with his insomnia that he can sometimes suffer from when he's super stressed out. And he's given me positive feedback about that too. So I don't foresee myself needing this or needing to buy a new supply anytime soon. But in those moments of stress and when my anxiety flares up, I know it's always there to help me. So yeah, CBD oil, check it out. It's very interesting, very helpful. So a friend of mine got me into essential oils. this year, specifically the Young Living brand of essential oils, and I just grabbed two random bottles of it for visual aid, right? Young Living, it's a little pricey, but I can tell you I have noticed a difference in the quality of the scent and in the quality of the oil. I know the Young Living brand, kind of like people try to make a business out of it and sell things. I just became a member or whatever just to get the discounted prices of the oils because they are so high quality. And I have the diffuser and it smells amazing. The oils I feel have been really helping my skin and helping me in other ways. So I guess this might be a good transition into more of the beauty side of the health and beauty favorites for 2017. This, for example, is the massage oil. It's called Dragon Time. And I think this 8-ounce bottle was around $30 if you have the membership discounted price option. And Dragon Time, it's specifically for when you're menstruating or when you're feeling the PMS. this is the massage oil, so it has the essential oils, but it's already diluted in their own proprietary blend of different carrier oils, because the essential oils are most of the essential oils that Young Living make. And for essential oils in general, just to be safe, since they are so potent because it's the concentrated essence of the plant, it's always a good idea to dilute it in a carrier oil. And so some of the carrier oils in here are like coconut oil and olive oil and different types of just kind of neutral carrier oils. And then this includes different essential oils that are good for female hormonal balance. Principally fennel oil, but especially clary sage oil. Clary sage is really good it's really good for balancing female hormones and estrogen and things like that. So they're in here, and whenever I start feeling crampy, I'll just pour a little bit into my hand and just rub it directly above where my uterus is, and it has helped me, no joke. Another thing that has helped me that kind of converted me to this is their Digize essential oil. Is this gonna focus? Yeah, Digize, D-I-G-I-Z-E. They have kind of funny names for some of their blends, because you can get single source oils like lavender, chamomile, peppermint essential oils, or you can get the blends that they make. And Digize is their digestive health blend. And if you get frequent heartburn, or if you feel bloated and have trapped gas and like, stomach issues are happening, what I'll do is I'll usually put a few drops of a carrier oil, like coconut oil, in my hand. Then I'll put 3 or 4 drops of this, mix it together, and literally rub it on my abdomen or above wherever it hurts. And within 10 minutes, the pain is relieved, whether it's trapped painful gas and bloating or upset stomach or heartburn. It's been a miracle. It's helped me a lot. It converted me. I was kind of dubious when my friend was talking about her experiences with using these essential oils on herself and on her small children. And I was like, oh, okay, let's try it out. At the very least, it'll smell good. But then when I used that topically and it was so effective, I just became a believer. You know? So, high quality. If you're interested in the benefits of essential oils, definitely go high quality, whether it's Young Living or doTERRA, I think, is another brand that's really high quality. Just invest in it and do a bunch of research. So I've been using a lot of these essential oils topically in my different homemade beauty care products. So, I don't wear makeup because it's just a personal choice, and I just can't stand how it feels on my face, and I hate washing it off. So when my beauty routine is fairly simple, and the routine kind of goes like this. In the evening, I only wash my face in the evening because my skin is very sensitive, and also the air up here in Massachusetts can get so dry because of the radiator heat and because of the cold. And so I only wash my face once a day in the evening before going to bed. And I just use this simple Trader Joe's spa face wash with tea tree oil, because I also, since my skin is so sensitive, it can also break out. I have combination skin. Like, it gets super dry, but it also gets really oily and breaks out. especially around certain times of the month and certain points in my cycle, like when I'm about to ovulate, and also when I'm about to have my period, I'll have a couple, especially around here, breakout spots. But this face wash from Trader Joe's, it's cheap. It's only like $6 or $7. You get 8.5 fluid ounces. A little bit goes a long way. And the list of ingredients is very hippy-dippy and very simple. Castile soap, coconut oil, some glycerin, tea tree oil, chamomile, flower extract, golden seal root extract. Basically the rest is just different types of essential oils or plant extracts. So it's very herbal and natural and hippie. I can pronounce all the ingredients. It's very safe. So I wash my face with this, and then I have made my own under eye serum because I'm about to turn 30 here in a couple weeks, so I definitely want to try to preserve my skin and take good care of it and pamper it as I age, right? So the under eye serum and the face serum that I use at night both have one key important ingredient, and that is evening primrose oil. And this is the bottle that I got. I got this bottle for $17, and it is 4 fluid ounces of very high quality evening primrose oil. And evening primrose oil, it's kind of a thick oil. I use it kind of as a carrier oil, but I mix in other types of oils too to kind of thin it out. But it's very, very good for women, especially. For hormonal acne breakouts and for healing acne and acne scars. It's just very, very nourishing for the skin on your face especially. So I highly recommend, if you like to make your own beauty products, like your own face serums and stuff like that, look into evening primrose oil, because earlier today, I was at my advisor's house because I had to babysit her son for a few hours, and she looked at me, she's like, the skin on your face looks great, what have you been doing? And I told her about evening primrose oil, and apparently she uses it too. So yeah, look into evening primrose oil. So my homemade under eye serum, which I just kind of recycled this little bottle. It's about maybe a third evening primrose oil, a third argan oil, and I'll go into argan oil here in a second, and a third jojoba oil. So three very nourishing but also very gentle oils that have really great benefits for the skin. They're easily absorbed, and keep in mind, I have sensitive combination skin, so I want to steer, if you have sensitive but kind of oily skin that's prone to breakouts, you kind of want to steer clear of the thicker oils, like olive oil, avocado oil or coconut oil, because those might cause breakouts. You want to focus more on the thin. The thinner the oil, the better. And that has to do with the ratio of, I think, linoleic versus oleic acid in the oils. But if I remember correctly, but just in general, you wanna focus more on the very light oils, and argan oil is one of those, and jojoba oil is one of the oils that most closely resembles the sebum, the oil that our face naturally produces. So it's also very gentle and very safe. So anyway, this is my under eye serum, and I'll just put a dot on my finger and then just gently pat it to the sensitive skin under my eyes. And then, keep in mind, this is my evening routine. I made my own facial serum and moisturizer. Again, evening primrose oil is a key ingredient in that. Evening primrose oil and argan oil are the main ingredients in my facial serum. I do not believe, it's been a while since I made this. Yeah, I did not put any essential oils in my evening facial serum because I really wanted the evening primrose oil to shine and to do most of the work. And I have to say, I think it has helped my skin tremendously just in the past few weeks that I've been using it. So yes, argan oil I also use as a hair serum, just straight up argan oil. And this is the Trader Joe's 100% organic argan oil. Argan oil can sometimes be a little bit pricey, but here you get 1.7 fluid ounces, and I think it's only like $8 or $9, and it's organic. It has a great scent to it, and argan oil is one of the lightest or thinnest oils that I've ever seen, and so that's why I use it on my hair, because I have very fine hair, like super fine, baby fine hair. And so if I try to put anything else on it as like to give it some shine, or to as like a post-wash conditioner or leave-in conditioner, everything else I've ever tried just weighs it down. But straight up argan oil, what I do is I put a drop on two or three of my fingers, I mix it like this, and then I just focus on the ends of my hair and run it through like so, and then I brush my hair out, and my hair looks great. It doesn't look greasy, and it helps to kind of condition the ends of my hair, which are my ends always, it's the first thing to get really dry and brittle on my super sensitive fine fucking hair. But anyway, gotta live with what you were given. So that is my evening routine. In the morning, I usually shower, or if I don't shower, I'll just splash my face with some water. I don't use the face wash on it in the morning, because if I washed it in the morning and in the evening, it would just dry out. And since I don't wear makeup, I don't have a reason to wash it that often, I feel. So after I shower, or I kind of splash my face down, I dry it off, and I put my morning face serum on it. This is a mixture of argan oil, apricot seed oil, and grapeseed oil, because all three of those oils, and I think some jojoba is in here too, but grapeseed and apricot kernel oil are very light oils and are also very good for acne prone oily skin. There's some grapeseed oil in my nighttime serum as well. Grapeseed, evening primrose, and argan, whereas this is grapeseed, apricot kernel, argan, and jojoba. And in here I have, and it smells so good, I have in this size bottle, which I think, I can't remember how big this bottle is, but if this is 1.7 fluid ounces, I would guess this is probably like a 4-ounce bottle. Yeah, this is 4 ounces. So this is a 4-ounce bottle. And my skin's super sensitive, so I had to go really light on the essential oils. So if you're thinking about making your own facial serum and you want to add essential oils for their benefits, start off really light, okay? So in this 4-ounce bottle, I only have, I think, 4 or 5 drops of tea tree oil, 5 to 7 drops of lavender, and then 5 to 7 drops of frankincense essential oil. That's it. Very light. You can barely notice it. You can smell, but it's, if you put more essential oils than that, it might kind of burn your skin a little bit. It might be too intense. So yeah, tea tree, lavender, and frankincense. And all three of those oils have great properties for your skin, especially if you're like me and you have that acne-prone, greasy skin. Tea tree oil is a natural antiseptic and can help heal acne. Lavender kind of calms your face down. And frankincense has anti-inflammatory properties, which can also heal scarring and nourish your face very well. So that is my morning facial serum. So I actually rub this not only on my face, I put it on my décolleté, on my chest, and on my upper back, on the back of my neck, and on my shoulders, anywhere where sometimes I have those breakouts, or anywhere where my skin's a little sensitive, and I want to nourish it with some oil. So I put this all over. And then after I put my morning serum, I let that kind of soak in for a few minutes, and then I put just one squirt of this face moisturizer. This is by Corinna Organics. I believe this is a company it's made in Vancouver, British Columbia, Canada. So I don't know how available this is in other parts of the country, but I'm in Massachusetts right now, and I got this at the hippie store, Cambridge Naturals. So since I'm fairly close to Canada, I think that's why I have access to it. But before I move back down to Georgia in January, I'm going to buy 2 or 3 more bottles of this. It's only $15, which for a really high quality, organic, safe, gentle face moisturizer, I think is pretty good. So I will be stocking up on this, because this is the first time ever in my life I have been able to buy a face moisturizer, like a facial lotion, without it making me break out. This is the first one ever, so I'm like, I will love you forever. So Corinna Organics Daily Face Moisturizer. I have no idea if you can order this online or not. Unfortunately, I don't know. I'm just gonna be stocking up on this. One of the reasons, or I think the reason why it doesn't break me out like everything else I've ever tried, is because the list of ingredients is so short and everything is so hippie, it's incredible. It's just coconut oil, palm oil, glycerin, pine extract, chamomile flower extract, nettle leaf extract, dandelion leaf extract, clover flower extract, and apple cider vinegar. That's it. That's it. There's no cetyl alcohol. There's no things that you can't pronounce. It's just, it's very hippie and very safe and very gentle. I just put one squirt in my hand. That much. Okay. Rub it in. And then I kind of just pat it into my face like this. And then whatever's left over, I either rub it on my upper body or I just use it kind of as a hand moisturizer. And it soaks in. It's so gentle. It is like the gentlest thing ever. And it also, it helps my skin from getting chapped and dry in this super dry air up here in Massachusetts. So yeah, if you have super sensitive skin, and you're looking or you're desperate to find a moisturizer that doesn't break you out, see if you can get your hands on some of this. Corinna Organics Daily Face Moisturizer. Yeah, so that is my evening and then morning face skincare routine, and I've been using this routine for the past month or so, and my skin, I believe, looks better, and I still break out, but instead of having like more intense breakouts, especially around here, it's just a couple spots, and within a day or so, they're gone. So yeah, and I attribute that especially to the evening primrose oil, and the essential oils that I put in, and the specific carrier oils that I mentioned. Okay, kind of along those lines of beauty, I've talked about these in previous favorites videos, but perfume. If you are on the market for a very affordable, but also vegan, cruelty-free, hippy-dippy perfume, I suggest checking out the Pacifico brand. I don't know if you'll be able to see it on this bottle or on this one. I don't know. Can you see that? There you go. There's Pacifica. I have the Tibetan Mountain Temple and the Persian Rose. I almost called this incense. Perfume. Perfume. And the Tibetan Mountain Temple smells like frankincense and spiciness and earthiness. And the Persian Rose is just straight up rose. This is a roller bottle. And it's so intense. It has good lasting power. It's a very hippie brand. You can find this at stores like Whole Foods, but you can also order from their website, pacifica.com. And it's very affordable. Like the 1 ounce bottle costs, I think, $20 or less. And then the roll-on stick, which is, I think, a little less than an ounce. Yeah, it's a third of an ounce. This is only $9. So for, I think, perfume that's really high quality, but also ethically made, it's super cheap and I love it and it smells good. So Pacifica, win. Okay, I think we have reached what I think is the most important health favorite of mine of 2017, and I mentioned this in my witchy favorites. This book, Taking Charge of Your Fertility, the 20th anniversary edition, so this is the updated edition, the definitive guide to natural birth control, pregnancy achievement, and reproductive health by Toni Weschler. And there she is. This book is so chock full of information of how the female reproductive system works. So the fertility awareness method, I can't go into too many details now, but it is a method that people use when they either want to do one of three basic things. So it's for people who want to achieve pregnancy, it's for people who want to avoid pregnancy, and it's also a great, I would say, diagnostic tool, and that's how I've been using it mainly this year, although I have also used it as a form of birth control to avoid pregnancy. I have only briefly taken hormonal birth control and I had very bad experiences with it. So I have actually been hormonal birth control free for nearly 5 years, for almost as long as I've been with my current partner, my husband. We would just use barrier methods before I discovered the fertility awareness method, condoms. And now that I'm more knowledgeable about how my body works and that I understand that there's only like a 7-day window where I could get pregnant, we use a mixture of barrier method when we know I'm fertile, and then when I know that my egg has dissolved away, we're free, okay? the fertility awareness method that I have learned by reading this book has been a game changer for me. I feel so much more empowered and informed about what's going on in my body. I also, for about a year and a half, struggled with recurrent yeast infections. Practically every month I would get a yeast infection after my period, and that, the word annoying just does not encompass how that felt. It was so frustrating. I cried so many times, and I went to so many different doctors. I went to the doctors at the health center. I talked to nurse practitioners. I talked to nurses and doctors at different clinics. I even went to the Massachusetts General Hospital Women's Clinic and talked to the head researcher of yeast, and her solution was for me to just keep taking antifungal pills, which are pretty hard on your liver. And that's when I just reached a breaking point. I knew that there had to be something else out there, some other way to understand why is this happening to me. Instead of just taking pills to cover up the symptoms, I wanted to get to the root of the cause. And just all these doctors and specialists I talked to, they weren't willing to go on that journey with me, or they just didn't have the right information. I don't know. So I did it myself, and I basically healed myself. And I learned through this method that my temperatures were low. Well, let me back up. Just very generally, the fertility awareness method, I use the symptothermal method, which means you check the type of cervical mucus you're producing to know when you might be fertile. And you also take your basal body temperature every morning. So I actually have my charts right here with me so I can show you. I have this binder, Rachel and Darío's Fertility Awareness and Reproductive Health. A friend of mine gave me this really great pencil case, feminist, so I keep all my pens and things in here. But I use this basal body thermometer. I ordered this from Walmart online. I don't think they carry it in their stores, but you can order this online. It was $9. It is an old school thermometer, so you have to shake it, right? But it's not mercury. It's mercury free, but it's an old school thermometer. I like it. I prefer this type of thermometer to a digital one, because the digital one, the batteries run down, and that can affect the accuracy of your chart. So this thermometer, assuming that I take care of it and I don't break it, it'll last the rest of my life. So I wake up in the morning, and I try to wake up around the same time every morning, and I take my temperature. I keep the thermometer for 3 minutes per the thermometer's instructions, and then when 3 minutes is up, I look at my temperature. Like today it was 98.2, and I record that on my chart. And this is what my chart looks like, and I printed this off for free online. I know there are all sorts of different apps, but I'm old school and I use a paper chart because just using more phone apps drives me nuts. So this is basically what my chart looks like, and these are my temperatures. You see how my temperature goes up and down at different points in my cycle? So in general, your temperature dips when your period starts, and your temperature stays more or less kind of low during your follicular phase, and then your ovary releases an egg, and then after the release of the egg, the temperature spikes. It goes up at least 0.3 degrees, and that's how you know exactly when you ovulate, like exactly when you ovulate. But that's also how you can know if there's something wrong. For example, if your temperatures get a little too low, like if you start dipping below 97.4 and go down into the low 97s or upper 96s, it could be a sign that you have a thyroid issue, and that can affect all sorts of different functions in your body, but including your hormonal balances and your fertility health, right? That's what I discovered, that I might have a very slight thyroid issue. And that makes sense because my dad has to take thyroid medication. His sister had to have surgery to remove part of her thyroid, and their cousin had thyroid cancer. And I told all this information to my doctors, and none of them wanted to test me for hypothyroid because I don't look like the typical hypothyroid case. But But that doesn't mean that my thyroid is fine just because I look fine, you know? And I had this recurring yeast infections and so I discovered on my own through my own research and hard work and patience and frustration that my temperatures were getting kind of low, and I learned that through charting. So based on that information, I started taking, and this is another 2017 health favorite, I started taking fermented cod liver oil mixed with concentrated butter oil made by Green Pasture. Green Pasture, I ordered this on Amazon because I haven't been able to find this in a physical store, but Green Pasture basically makes very high quality, organic, ethically made and processed supplements, especially cod liver oil and different fish liver oils. And this is mixed with pasture raised organic butter oil concentrate. And basically, this of course is not for vegans, but basically in the West, in industrialized countries, about 90% of us have vitamin D deficiency. And we've all been taught that you can get vitamin D by being out in the sun. But actually, our ancestors, from what I've read, from what I know, and again, I'm not a dietitian, I'm not a nutritionist, this is just my own experience and my own research, right? Our ancestors got vitamin A, vitamin D, and vitamin K2 through animal sources, especially through eating the organ meats and the liver. I know liver is kind of gross. I'm not sure if I'm ready to take that step to start eating liver. But I have noticed since taking just two of these a day, cod liver, high quality cod liver oil pills, just by taking two of these a day, the quality of my menstrual blood has improved. It has become more vibrant and bright red and healthy. My temperatures on my chart started to go up a little, so I wasn't down in like hypothyroid zone below 97.4, and I feel like my skin looks better. That also might be in conjunction with the homemade face serums that I talked about. But also, and most importantly, the yeast infection stopped. And I feel like I feel more balanced hormonally. And according to my charts, for the past few months, I have ovulated every month, and my body has been doing what it needs to do in a healthy way. And so this has been a game changer in conjunction with the fertility awareness method that I have researched and implemented. I've learned so much. The fertility awareness method, like I mentioned, it's not just for people trying to achieve pregnancy or avoid pregnancy. It's also for people to learn more about your body, because if there is an issue in your menstrual cycle, chances are that's a sign of a greater problem, or that's a sign that something else in a different part of your body might need some attention. You know, like PCOS, polycystic ovary syndrome, is often linked to issues with insulin and having insulin resistance, right? Recurring yeast infections could be a sign of a thyroid issue. It can be a window into your overall health, the health of your liver, the health of your glandular system, your blood sugar levels. It's everything is connected. Everything is connected. And so that's why it's so important. Even if you don't suspect there's anything, you don't have any issues or health issues that you want to look into, if you have ovaries and a uterus, and if you are a menstruating person, and it doesn't matter how you identify yourself gender-wise or sexuality-wise, it doesn't matter if you want kids or not, I cannot recommend this book enough, and I cannot recommend this method enough to learn about your body and to have a greater, more holistic understanding of your health. For real, this is one of the most important books that I read in my life, and is definitely the most important book that I read this year. It's a game changer. Just a game changer. So I'll end this video on that, because now, 58 minutes. Okay, yes, we are approaching an hour. Game changer. Please, if you have a uterus and ovaries, and if you are currently in menstruating age, just no matter if you're taking hormonal birth control, if you have an IUD, whatever, just read this book. Just educate yourself. I can talk about this for days and days, and which is why I have a fertility awareness playlist on my channel, and I'm thinking of dedicating the entire month of February to fertility awareness, just my experiences with it, and also talking more in depth about the information in this book and things related to fertility awareness. So I'm thinking about making February fertility February. So be on the lookout for that if you are interested in learning more, or just getting more feedback from someone practicing the method before diving in. Because it is kind of daunting and scary at first, like realizing like, oh shit, I can have unprotected sex with my partner and he can finish, and you know, I don't have to be like counting the days until my period, because I know at that point my egg was dead. Like, you know, real shit. It's so empowering and liberating. So yes, I'll end this video on that. Be on the lookout for Fertility February, and now that I think of it, I'll include in the description box below, I'll include the Amazon link to things like the cod liver oil that I mentioned, or the CBD oil, or the evening primrose oil, and things like that, in case anyone's interested. But again, I'm not a specialist, this is just me talking about my experiences, so maybe I sparked some interest, so you can go and do your own research and make your own decisions. So, yes, my 2017 health and beauty favorites. Okay, I'll stop rambling. Until next time, many blessings. Bye.